Yanni Ricasari.
Okay, hello to everyone. It's really nice to see you all here. So my name is Janne Rikassaari, and I'm going to give you my 10 minutes overview of IoT, industrial IoT, and talk about the kind of a practical way to implement these things. But before I jump into the real agenda, couple of words about Klinkmann. So even the company name sounds a bit German. Klinkmann is a Finnish company, and we have operations in Finland. Company owner is a Finnish family, but then we also have activities in all the Baltic countries, so Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, also something in Belarus, Ukraine, Kazakhstan, and we have 6 sales offices also in Russia. So for some reason, we are a bit east from Finland also. We are a distributor company and we represent some major automation brands here in Finland and let's say in our territory where we are operating. Today, we are going to take a view of the Wonderwear, but all the companies who we are representing, they have some sort of IoT strategy also in their hands. So, most of the people here have been talking about the value of IoT and what does it bring to us. The IoT itself basically doesn't give you any value. It's the business behind the IoT. You need to think about the business strategy. And over the last couple of years, we have been talking lots with the customers about the IoT. There has been many, many exhibitions and many cases where customer is giving, or let's say, people are coming to us and asking, you have this IoT, what do you have to sell to me? And I think the clear answer to that question is, what does the IoT mean to you? If it doesn't mean anything to you, then I think you don't need it. So first you have to think about the strategy. So everything, the true impact is actually coming from the meaningful business. You need to find something out of the IoT and then start to make the implementation. Let's take a simple approach. There's a kind of our view is to make a kind of a 4-step approach how to get into this one after you have made the decision what you are going to do with the IoT itself. What is the business behind the IoT? So the way we see it is quite simple. First, make a connection either by using some existing automation system or make some additional sensoring to get the data out of the industrial application, industrial system. Either it's a machine or process or the way how you want to see it. Then once you have the sensoring or the connectivity, then collect the data. And for that one, either it's an on-premise application where you collect the data or it can be a cloud solution. Once you have the data, then you need to clarify it. You need to make kind of a meaningful information out of the data what you have available and after that one, once you have the, let's say, meaningful reports and data available, then please close the loop and make a business decision based on that one. So it doesn't have to be rocket science on any way. Of course, there are lots of details in every step which has to be solved, but basically this is the way how we want to take. There are lots of opportunities behind the IoT, so how you can make the business. One of the, I think the most common way to see it is it's kind of a predictive maintenance, predictive data analytics, and it can be something related to material consumption or some predictive maintenance or some support activities you are doing for the customers. But of course, it also gives you valuable information for the system design, for example, for a machine builder. It gives you really, really good information how the machines are performing on the field, and by that way you can bring that one as a closed loop back to the design board and makes, for example, some better decisions for your systems. Can be related to some facility management applications, so energy consumption, maybe something related to regulatory compliances. So in some cases, some industries simply require some reporting back to the authorities, and that's one way to make a business out of this one. And of course, it can be something related to centralized operations. So it can be something remotely operated, or how do you want to see it? From the platform point of view, I think we have seen several platforms already today, but what I want to show is related to Wandeware. So Wandeware, first of all, it's a software company, and we have been in this business more than 30 years, starting the business with the traditional HMI applications. Recently, what we have been doing in Finland has been somehow related to manufacturing operation systems, so MES applications. There are really good references at the moment, for example, from the food and beverage industry. And I think we have been one of the first companies who have been introducing, for example, cloud-based historian applications. But the first step has always been the connectivity, so how to make the connections. And I think at the moment we have one of the best connectivity platforms, connectivity suites for the industrial applications. So practically we can connect to every automation system or automation vendor. So until now we haven't found a system that we are not able to connect. So that's the first step. So connectivity, and then once you have that one, then how to collect. This is a simple way. There is a cloud-based solution called Wandeware Historian. So with that one, you can easily store the data into the Azure-based cloud application. And there are ready-made tools, so all those tools that you can see on, or let's say those tablets and phones you can see on the screen, those applications are ready-made, so you basically you don't have to do anything. Just make a connection to the cloud and you get the information easily out of that one. The data can be anything, so we are not strictly tied to anything. So it can be a machine, it can be a process, it can be site, it can be power plant, it can be an amusement park, whatever you want to see. So depending on the application and depending on the data, what you want to store. This is a simple, really, really simplified architectural picture. So make a connection to the cloud from your site, and after that one, you have a possibility to use ready-made tools, or you can take the data into your own data lake and use the data for the further analysis purposes. So depending how it's needed and what is essential. Then the next thing is to clarify the data. So for some, let's say there are different interest groups in industry who are interested about the different kind of data. It can be raw data, for example, some trends for the maintenance persons. It can be some analytics, some KPI, business-related KPIs for the decision makers who want to see how the business is behaving and makes decision based on that one. Or it can be some static reports, for example, production batch related, how much we have produced, what we have done, and how much we have consumed raw material, etc. So different ways to see. Or some mobile solutions. So it's also possible to bring the data into your watch, and for example, if you are sitting next by the boiler and the boiler is just about to explode, I think it would be nice to get the alarm into your watch and gives to the 15 seconds to run. We are more or less everywhere, so we have at the one third of the industrial sites in our customer portfolio at the moment. So I think it's about 900,000 licenses all over the world at the moment. We work together with some, let's say, major players on the industry, but we are happy to talk more with each and everyone. So we have a booth somewhere there behind the room, and I'm there with my colleague, and if you have any further questions, so please come and let's talk a little bit more. Thank you.